Good morning. I am Dr.S.Sheeba, working as a faculty in Department of EEE, Sri Krishna College of Engineering, Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu, India. I am here to explain the concept of embedded systems with you. Embedded systems is the buzzword all around. There are two keywords, embedded and system. And we always keep wondering, what is this behind embedded and system? A system, I want to explain first. System is something in which we organize or do tasks based upon a predetermined plan or a program. It is even arranging objects in an organized manner according to our own fixed plan. Take the example of a watch. In our watch, there is this time display system which is going on, which is displaying the time of the hour. And this watch has hardware components in it. Example, the needles, which is working according to the predetermined plan. When we take the example of a watch, we have the long needle and the short needle, which is the hour, minutes, and even the seconds needle, which works in clockwise direction and according to the predetermined set of rules, and all of them cross each other once in 12 hours. And that is how the watch functions. This is a system. What do we mean by embedded system? Embedded system is nothing but I have a hardware, I have a software, I embed my software onto my hardware to run a predetermined application. So here I have this hardware chip and the software program code is written, and I try to embed it onto the chip to make a specific application work. So we can define embedded system as a computer hardware in which a software is embedded as its important component. So today, our real world is full of embedded systems all around. Take the example of robotics. From the robot which went to Mars rover and captured the Mars pictures, and it really created a hype on internet in the 1990s. That robot is an embedded system. Today, if we go to a hospital to take a MRI scan, it is another embedded system. Take the example of the smartphone in which I am being videotaped now. It is another embedded system. Take the example of the Wi-Fi connectivity, the concept behind this Digi Guru in which I upload my video and it's visible all over. There lies embedded system. And in all consumer electronics and smart buildings, everywhere we have embedded systems all around us. Even take the example of automotives, where a single car has more than 400 embedded systems in it. Hence, to understand the concept of embedded system, I would like to explain the characteristics of embedded systems with five main features. Any embedded systems should have five characteristics. One is, it should possess a complex algorithm. There should be a complex algorithm in a predefined manner which is working in it. Another thing is GUI, graphical user interface. It might be LEDs, it might be buttons, it might be user-friendly applications where the application can be sorted out. And another important characteristics is real time. And everything should work on time, not at a past defined time. And another main application is any embedded system should be able to carry out many tasks at the same time. Multitasking. Take the example of our smartphone. We are able to send SMS. We are able to connect it over Bluetooth or Wi-Fi, At the same time, we are able to take a photograph. And finally, the fifth characteristics is dedicated function. Any embedded system is not going to work on all-purpose, general-purpose applications, but it will drive a dedicated function of its own. I want to explain this concept using two real-time examples. Take the example of this microwave oven which we use in our kitchen daily. So this microwave oven has got these five characteristics inherently embedded in it. First is, it works on real time. Hence I call it as an embedded system. I set the timer and the cooking is done in real time. Second is, it has got a complex algorithm. The cooking doesn't happen in a single routine fashion. I can either grill my raw material, or I can roast it, or do the baking of a cake. And the third characteristic is, it's got complex GUIs for user-friendly applications. There are various timer buttons and switches in which I can toggle the modes and I can use it. And fourth is dedicated function. It works on a dedicated function according to the menu selection. And the fifth characteristic is multi-rated. It works at different rates for different time of cooking. So this is one example, and the next example would be a smartwatch, where we find this smartwatch in all the students' hands. So this smartwatch is able to act as a pedometer. Using the smartwatch, I'm able to send messages, attend calls, take up musics, and even use it as an MP3 phone. So the same way, it has got these five characteristics. One is real time. It works on real time by receiving the up-to-date messages and calls. And the second would be complex algorithms. It can even be used as a mobile tracker. And the third is complex GUIs. The various features on the smartwatch, the touch and the haptic features help us to message and listen to music. And the fourth character is dedicated functions. I can enable and synchronize it with a calendar, with my smartphone, etc. And finally, it is multi-rated also, having a multitask application such as receiving message, videos at different predetermined rates. Hence, I call my smartwatch an embedded system. What makes up the embedded system? It is the hardware, the software, and the real-time OS which supervises these both. So we have the software, the hardware, and the real-time OS. These are the three main components of any embedded system. Hardware. What is the hardware in an embedded system? It is the processor, the timers, the input-output controls, the LED modules, the mouse, the interfaces, etc. Software. It is the language, the source code, the programming which I do. And who's taking care of those both is a real-time operating system which is supervising the hardware and the software. Now, when I say embedded system concept, a very important factor we have to note is how expensive my embedded system is going to be. So, how do I define the cost of my embedded system? So, I have to define it in terms of the power consumption. I'm using a processor in which there are a lot of add-on features, but how many features do I take it up for my application? So, how is the chip going to consume power? If the power is going to be more, the heat is also going to be more. The space is going to be more. The programming features are also going to be complex. Am I going to use a chip with added extra features which are not going to be used for that application? That is the question which arises, and that is the R&D concept behind embedded development. I use a specific processor, and that's how the ARM processor came into existence. It would be a specialized processor for the specialized application rather than wasting on the entire microcontroller such as 8051 etc. to work on that particular application. The need for explaining this concept of embedded systems is because India has got a lot of potential with the upcoming embedded industry market, and we could really be one of the potential contributors to our country's economy. Take the example of South India, especially Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, where Bangalore has become a R&D hub for many companies like the Airbus, GE, Huawei, Alstom, etc. And also Tamil Nadu, Chennai is called the Detroit, where all the automotive electronic hubs have been started up, and nothing can work without embedded system. In our own very hometown, Coimbatore, there are top 7 IT exporters in our own city with L&T, GE, Precol, LMW, Suzlon, and even Bosch having its R&D center. And the opportunities are plenty, with many certifications available in embedded system such as CLED, NI Instruments, NIE LIT, even in ARM some certifications can be done. So I think this concept of embedded systems would drive you to great heights to become potential contributors of our Indian economy. Thank you.